this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV, The After Years. Why are we making a pit stop here again? Well, I guess we're kind of in the neighborhood. Lally-ho! I'm surprised I was able to get my voice up that high today. Well, there you go. Sometimes you just never know. What do you mean by that? Don't answer that, viewers. Oh, she's just doing fine. Okay. Out of the way. You. Well, you're not going to say 1, 2, 3, lally-ho? Aww. I wanted them to say that again. You might want to add to that, what have we here? Nah, just kidding. I thought Luca was around. Huh. Shouldn't you have a second throne for her? Oh, yeah, you wouldn't know us. I like how he calls them a pair. As though he can instantly tell that they're twins. Well, I suppose they do kind of have the same blank expression on their face. Oh, I'm teasing. Because you've never met us before, aside from one time, like, I don't know, what? 7, 8 years ago, maybe? Luca! Yo! I don't know why. I just find that of you. Maybe it's just because it's Palom. I don't know. Well, if you call having a belly stylish, okay, I suppose so. I've got a belly and I don't think that's stylish. But anyway. Oh, we were just here to heckle you about how we're going to be traveling all over your underworld and there's nothing you can do about it. But yeah, absolutely. I want to be a sage, after all. Sages before mages. Okay, then. Sounds like a plan. Well, what else do you want me to do? How rude! That's not a Full House reference. That, well, it might be, but I've never seen the show. Or at least not very much of it. That's from a movie that I've tried to purge from my memory. It's Jar Jar, okay? Thank you for bringing back those memories. Well, that was my own fault, but still, that's the reference. Oh, yeah, we don't need to bring her along. Sounds vulgar. Yeah, she would just be getting in the way. We don't need her in this tale. No, I was just jacking with you. Yahoo! Wahoo! Man, Palom, you got all the ladies hitting on you. You animal. Well, okay, let's take a look around then. We don't have access to the entire castle, but we can look around for some treasure as long as we're here. Why not? Let's go down here first, I think. Yeah, I'm surprised they all recognize me. Interesting that a female dwarf would say, "Hey, the guy with the drill!" I'm just saying! Because the ones in the red are the female dwarfs. That's why. Shut up! I don't think they sell anything interesting here, but they do have money lying around. And unlike the last tale, yeah, it was the last tale, wasn't it? But we can go into the towers again and grab their treasure. They're going to make this more complicated on us, aren't they? Nuts. Well, I'll just quick go in and out. Yeah, good thing we got those Hermes sandals, because Porom doesn't learn haste for a long time. All's well that ends well. Or, wait a minute, that's another game. Oh, so far, so good. How do they have trees down here? That is my question to you, viewers. Of course, they have living plants attacking everyone, so why not trees? This one's much easier. I don't think there's any actual equipment that I care about here, but, well, we'll take what we can get. Okay, I think that's all the treasure. No, that's not all the treasure in the castle. We gotta go to the other side of the basement there. Dance. We like the, okay. And the developer's room is still empty. I think they sell the same things that they sold in... Oh. Yeah, I think they're still selling the same things that they sold in the previous town. Mist, there. And if you try going to the basement there, yeah, it's under construction, so there's nothing you can do there. Oh, well. Okay, let's head on over to the Feymark then. The enemies there should be easy enough. Oh, Luca doesn't actually join the party, by the way. But, yeah, let's head on over there. Why not? I mean, Luca's hanging out with us, but, I guess she wants Palom to hit on her some more. Maybe she's not into the male dwarves. Well, he is kind of a shorty, but, yeah. Okay. I'm not crying! I'm not nervous. Well, yeah, of course. How can she help you with a landing? Well, however that works. You can go back on the airship and use the healing pot there if you really want to. Yeah, you're just... Well, you'll have your time to shine, Luca. Well, what else are we here for? You're not going to tell us, are you? Oh, yeah, we've been having airship trouble the whole time, but we weren't going to tell you until after we got here. Hey, what happened to you, Palom? Well, anyway... Let's head on through the Feymark. But what about all those lava tiles? Nah, just like Rydia's tale... I almost said Luca's tale, but no. Yeah, just like Rydia's tale, you don't need to worry about that. You don't need float or anything to get around here anymore. So... Alright, there we go. Yeah, it was kind of annoying to have to... do that all the time. Or switch it up all the time like that. Well, we got the fire arrows. Those can be useful for... Porom there. I'm just gonna run around now because the battles are easy enough. Oh, there's a new band that we can learn too. Let's see if I can get a chance to use it. Yeah, now we're actually gonna start getting some, well, better equipment. Okay, we got Trance here. Let's see. Fortunately, since it's a full moon, our black magic is really powered up. So, just use Fear on these guys, and you can take them out even at relatively low levels. So, that's pretty nice. I like how they set up the moon that way for this tale. Cottage, awesome. What are we walking on, anyway? Is it supposed to be like some kind of tree or something? I don't know. I like how they keep the save point there to keep it consistent with Rydia's tail there. Nice touch. Let's see, Blizzara should be good on these guys. I don't know that they have any elemental affinities. I would guess maybe they resist. Uh-oh. I would guess they resist fire, but I don't know. But they're all dealt with easily enough. You could kill off Palom and Rydia to get more experience for Porom in her own tail. This is Porom's tail, right? Not Palom's tail, part two? Oh, I'm not complaining, but... Oh yeah, by the way, she has 27 spirit. Give her this surplice. Now she has 32 spirit, so she got two more multipliers out of it. And what is a surplice anyway? I guess it's some kind of robe or a dress or some sort. I don't know. Come on, you can do better than that. Come on, Palom. You suck, Palom. Oh, they're not resistant to fire. Okay. Well, never mind then. Carry on. Yeah, I guess, physical attacks are being reduced here, so... Porom's arrows, not so useful. Oh, wow. Uh-oh. Now, against the... Not the Quirrell, the... Kaxith. I know that's not how you pronounce it, but... Let's use Break on these guys, see how that works. Well, we got the one I care about, so... what spell? Oh, okay. I meant to use Blizzara, but I guess I screwed up. Oh yeah, Porom has a new prey command now, too. It's a lot better than Rosa's prey command, but I do like the reference there. Yeah, I don't want to go into that center tile yet. Oh, crap. That's really bad for us. That really sucks. Even my prey command is down now, too. Well, we gotta take out the Kaxith, so... Nuts! We gotta take him out in one shot, or he'll counterattack. What happened to your physical attack? I thought they were supposed to be boosted. Come on, then. Oh, yeah, Rydia has all her summons. Screw it, I'm using Chocobo. Just like the Roadrunner. Ah, you gotta get that non-elemental damage somehow. Well, okay, let's go check out the Eidolons, then. What's going on, Rydia? The mysterious girl hasn't shown up yet. What do you mean by that? Yeah, there's no monsters down below. Of course, they did train Rydia to use summons. Right. We already knew that. Well, everyone you were in sync with before was kind of dead. So, you didn't really lose much. Of course, you would kind of lose the rest of your childhood. But then you get to skip all the awkward puberty moments, so... It didn't cause any problems in the first game. Although Cecil and Rosa do look like they are 60 years old. So, God, and that FMV, holy cow. I was watching it before I recorded the episode today, and it's like, man, there is no way they're in their 30s. No, I don't promise. I want to come in with you. No! But thou must! Ah, yeah. Well, she wanted to use our airship. I just find it odd that Palom would react that way for some reason. But then again, I find everything Palom does hilarious. So. Huh? Not right now, Stripe. I'm almost done here. No. Down. Down. Naughty kitty. She's just desperate for attention. Come on, I want to visit the Fame Arc. Oh, okay. But will Porm ever get her moment to shine in her own tale? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV, The After Years. This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!